Early morning, Delhi. A raid is in progress. The target, one of India's millions of quack doctors. Fake medical practitioners, like the notorious leader of a multi-billion rupee kidney racket, nicknamed Dr. Horror. Millions of these imposters cause untold misery across India. Some have killed and maimed.
I couldn't imagine my baddest dream that this could happen with me.
They work outside the law, but are sought out by desperate patients. Hunted by medical authorities, they are elusive and cunning. They are rampant and dangerous.
Quacks are worse than the terrorists, and they should be punished severely.
Undercover Asia enters the underbelly of India's medical sector to expose the unholy hands of quacks and crooks. A team of doctors and officials assembles at India's Directorate of Health Services in North Delhi, charged with a unique role. Hunting down India's quack doctors.
This is a special case. It was in North District. Till now, we are having only one pending case. That's why we had planned.
The team has received a complaint against someone offering medical services without qualifications. After a quick discussion, the team heads out.
Basically, we had received complaint from this particular area, and we had kept it very confidential. Firstly, we are going to the police station to have a police constable with us.
At the local police station, the team seeks permission to conduct the inspection with police backup. With the details approved, the police team gets ready to escort the health officials.
Sandeep, gaadi ready kar le, staff ko taiyar kar bitha.
The team heads into one of the poorest parts of Delhi. This is the realm of the quack. They must catch the man red-handed. Only then can they hope to press charges. But when they arrive, they are in for a disappointment.
Doctor ne bataya tha ki main har tarike ka ilaaj karta hu, jo generally ye uske pagalpan ka treatment kar raha tha, aur usko psychotropic drug de raha tha, kafi samay se usko bekuf bana raha tha. जब उसने बाहर दिखाया तो उसे पता चला कि ये सारी दवाइयाँ गलत चला रहा है शुरू में इसने ये बताया था कि मैं क्वालिफाइड डॉक्टर हूँ लेकिन ये कोई क्वालिफाइड डॉक्टर नहीं था और ये इस तरीके से ये लोग बेवकूफ़ बनाते हैं लोगों को जब उसकी कंप्लेंट हुई तब हम यहाँ छापा मारने आए लेकिन उससे पहले ये यहाँ से भाग गया
प्रोसीजर में हमारी कुछ कमियाँ ऐसी हैं हो सकता है इन्फॉर्मेशन मिली और बंद करके चले गए हों तो क्योंकि अभी तो कोई बोर्ड भी नहीं है कुछ नहीं पता लग रहा है तो वी कांट से एनीथिंग कि यहाँ पर कब से नहीं है
द पीपल ऑफ द नेबरहुड आर टाइट-लिप्ड and offer little information. Some say his clinic has been shut for 3 months, others, 1 day. It soon becomes clear why they are so evasive.
हमारे यहाँ कोई MBBS डॉक्टर ही नहीं है, हमें MBBS डॉक्टर की जरूरत है। कोई ना कोई तो यहाँ तो पास में कोई हॉस्पिटल हो, या MBBS डॉक्टर हो, कुछ भी तो नहीं है यहाँ पर। लोग बात करे तो करे क्या? अब इमरजेंसी में रात को कोई 11-12 बजे बीमार होता है तो इन्हीं के पास आना पड़ता है।
The raid is a snapshot of India's medical crisis. Corruption, greed, and malpractice are rampant. And the rot has set in deep.
Unfortunately, there are the people of the country are caught between two evils. One is a non-performing public sector, and on the other hand, a very greedy, non-transparent, and ill-performing corporate Medicare sector.
There is a chronic shortage of qualified doctors. Opening the door to millions of fake practitioners. It is estimated that there are over 2.5 million quacks in India, with over 60,000 in the capital city of Delhi alone. Studies reveal one doctor for every 1,700 patients in the country, And because the doctor-patient ratio is so low, a large percent of India's 1.2 billion people end up in the dangerous hands of quacks.
Situation is very, very bad in the country. There are more than 10 lakhs of quacks in the whole country. If one quack is spoiling one case in a year, this means every few seconds, one person is suffering at their hand.
The story of 12-year-old Bilal shows how a single fake doctor can destroy lives. Bilal shares a room with his family of five. He wants to be an art teacher, but the family is crushingly poor. Two years ago, Bilal was playing with his friends when he fell and cut his knee. Neighbors rushed Bilal to a private clinic. They had no idea that the doctor who attended to him was not qualified. The quack leaves a 2-inch shard of glass embedded deep in Bilal's leg.
टेढ़ा ही रख रहा था मम्मी मेरा पैर कट जाएगा मेरे पैर में कंचे कंचे दवाई वाई दी मैंने देने के बाद इसको कम से कम 3-4 घंटे हो गए तड़पते हुए फिर मेरे हस्बैंड गए वहाँ डॉक्टर से बात करी उन्होंने कहा नहीं दवाई दोगे तो आराम होगा फिर भी आराम नहीं हुआ फिर 1-1.5 घंटा और करके मैं आगे फिर मैं पहुँची मैंने उनसे तेज़ी से बोली थी मैंने कहा मेरा बच्चा तड़प रहा है दवाई खाने के बाद तो कुछ आराम होता है मैंने कहा उसको तो बिल्कुल भी नहीं हो रही है फिर एक गोली और लिख दी उसने फिर वो दवाई दी उससे भी कोई फ़र्क नहीं हुआ फिर हम 2:30-3 बजे परेशान हो गए मैंने उनसे कहा मैंने कहा जब बच्चा ही नहीं सो रहा तो हम कहाँ से सोएंगे मैंने कहा कुछ तो तकलीफ है इसके
For Bilal and his family, it was the beginning of a nightmare. They rushed from hospital to hospital trying to find out what was wrong. And in one overcrowded government hospital, doctors ignore the results of an X-ray that clearly shows the glass fragment.
उसके बाद डॉक्टर कोई राउंड पर आए, उन्होंने हमें इस बच्चे की टांग इतनी हो गई थी, जैसे आप 3 टांगे लगा लो, इतनी हो गई थी, छाले पड़ गए थे इसपे, और ये चीख रही है। अब उन्होंने सीनियर जो आए थे, उन्होंने उठा के मेरे हस्बैंड को, मुझे मेरे बच्चे को, गार्ड को बुला के धक्के देके हमें बाहर निकाल दिया। अब मेरे को तो ऐसे ही लगेगा जब सब अस्पतालों से निकाल दिया तो मेरा तो बच्चा बचेगा नहीं।
It took 3 days to get a proper diagnosis. By then, the damage is done.
तीसरे दिन फिर लेके गए इसको। वहाँ डॉक्टर को दिखाया, एक्सरे भी दिखाया। तो कह लगे इसको तो शीशा है। मैंने हम तो शुरू से कह रहे शीशा है इसके अंदर। यानी जो ऑपरेशन हुआ इसका। तो उसको हाथ का तो ऑपरेशन करने ले गए अंदर ही।
उन्होंने ना बेहोश करा इसे, ना कोई सुई लगाई ना कुछ कैंची दो पकड़ के ऐसे खींचा उन्होंने शीशा
यानी कि 3 दिन के बाद शीशा निकाला उसका
Bilal's leg is infected and gangrene sets in now the family face catastrophe
इसकी रिपोर्ट लेके हम सर गंगाराम में किसी ने बताया वहां लेके जाओ उसकी रिपोर्ट तो हम वहां लेके गए उसको वहां दिखाया तो वो कह रहे भाई इसके जो है पैर कटेगा
मैं बहुत परेशान हुई इसकी टांग काट के 10 किलो की थैली में दे दी लाके हमने दोनों ने मेहनत करके इसके 2 दिन ऑपरेशन करा दिए अब हमारे पैसा वैसा कुछ नहीं है उनमें 2-3 लाख की कर्जदार में हैं हम लोग मेरी नौकरी भी छूट गई 2 मेरे से बड़े लड़के हैं वो 9वीं 10वीं में थे मैंने उनको पढ़ाई छुटा के मैंने काम पे लगा दिया दोनों काम कर रहे हैं उससे मेरा घर चल लिया है लेकिन मेरे को ना इन लोगों ने बहुत बर्बाद कर दिया मेरे घर जिंदगी खराब कर दी इन लोगों ने डॉक्टरों ने
The encounter with a quack doctor cost Bilal and his family dear. They paid only $2 for the stitches, but over the next 2 years, they would end up spending over $7,000 to help their son.
बहुत ज़्यादा कठिनाई चल रही है। रोजगार की तरफ से परेशान हैं। अब जो भी पास पहले था सब कुछ लगा चुके हैं। अब इसका एक और ऑपरेशन है तो उसके बारे में भी सोचना है। तो उसके पास गुंजाइश नहीं हो पा रही हमारी। अब इसी कोशिश में लगे पड़े हैं कुछ ऐसा हो जाए बच्चे के लिए ताकि आगे इसकी ज़िंदगी बन जाए कुछ
But Bilal's story is just one of the thousands of stories that make the headlines, a casualty of India's legion of quacks. Often one step ahead of the law, and always ready to shut up shop at one place and move to another, they are the invisible tribe of unholy hands. India's health sector is a national scandal. Spending on healthcare is among the lowest in the world. A paltry 1.2% of its GDP goes towards public healthcare, creating a deficit of qualified doctors. And where Indian doctors and hospitals fail, an army of quacks steps in.
So basically, these are entrepreneurial, self-styled, self-proclaimed doctors. So it's an entrepreneurial world in healthcare market. And you know, when you talk of profit in healthcare, you can only build that profit on flesh and blood.
But for those who have lost their loved ones, these quacks are nothing less than murderers. Rajesh's father was a diabetic who needed medical care. An injury prompted them to consult a neighborhood doctor who gave him an insulin injection.
उन्होंने इंजेक्शन भरा मेरे पिताजी चारपाई पर ऐसे इस तरह से बैठे हुए थे और मेरे पिताजी को उन्होंने इंजेक्शन यहाँ लगा दिया वो इस तरह से मतलब ऐसे बैठे हुए ऐसे लगाया इंजेक्शन उन्होंने वो इंजेक्शन लगाया मैंने उसी टाइम उनको टोका डॉक्टर साहब आपने ये इंजेक्शन गलत लगाया है मैंने इंजेक्शन मेरे पिताजी की जान पर पेट पर लगता है लेकिन ना तो यहाँ लगाया किसी डॉक्टर ने और आपने यहाँ पर लगाते समय ये भी नहीं देखा पकड़ के कि कोई नस तो नहीं है ना आपने ऐसे छुआ ना कुछ करा इंजेक्शन भरा और सीधा आपने ऐसे लगा दिया मैंने किसी नस में चले जाए गलत वो मेरे को बोल रहा तू डॉक्टर है मैं डॉक्टर हूँ
Rajesh's father had fallen into the hands of a quack and it killed him.
और उसी रात मेरे पिताजी की डेथ हो गई चार पांच दिन बाद मैं उस डॉक्टर की दुकान पर गया मैंने डॉक्टर साहब को बोला मैं डॉक्टर साहब मैंने आपको मैंने बोला था ना इंजेक्शन गलत लग गया मेरे पिताजी की डेथ हो गई कह रहा मरना ही था उसको मर गया तो मैं क्या करूं
The toll across India is vast. Dheeraj Solanki had no idea that it would take all of one day to turn his life upside down.
My wife was 2 months pregnant. So, I nearby a lady doctor. She claimed to be a gynecologist. She was on the board that she was a gynecologist. So, I said, she is nearby. So, I was going to follow up for her. In the month of May 2012, Sunday was the day. So, morning, high fever for vomiting started early morning. उन्होंने नियर बाई में एक हॉस्पिटल था तो हमारे घर के पास में ही है सत्यम हॉस्पिटल वहाँ की विजिटिंग कंसल्टेंट भी थी तो उन्होंने वहाँ के लिए रेफ़र कर दिया मैंने वहाँ पे आके मेरे को एडमिट करा दिया एडमिट कराने के बाद उन्होंने ट्रीटमेंट स्टार्ट कर दिया जो भी वहाँ पे डॉक्टर थे उन्होंने अटेंड करा उनको पूरे दिन तबीयत डिटर्ड होती रही अच्छा संडे का दिन था वो फ़ोन पर ही ट्रीटमेंट कराती रही मतलब इनकी ना तो उन्होंने मना करा कि मैं नहीं आ पाऊँगी
But time was running out. And when the gynecologist doesn't turn up, Dheeraj rushes his wife to two different hospitals. At the second, his wife dies. Then Dheeraj made a shocking discovery.
उनमें से किसी ने बताया कि आप गलत जगह चले गए मगर जी कैसे कह रहे जी जो लेडीज आप जो जो लेडी डॉक्टर है वो जो अपने आप गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट कहती है वो गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट है ही नहीं दूसरे ये कि आप जिस हॉस्पिटल में गए उनके डॉक्टर भी ऐसे ही हैं उसके बाद हमने फिर उसको इन्वेस्टिगेट करना स्टार्ट किया आरटीआई लगाई दिल्ली मेडिकल काउंसिल के अंदर कि भाई इसकी क्वालिफिकेशन बताई जाए
इट वाज द बिगिनिंग ऑफ अ लॉन्ग क्वेस्ट फॉर जस्टिस Dheeraj's daughter वाज ओनली 9 एट द टाइम शी हैज बीन ग्रैपलिंग विद द लॉस ऑफ हर मदर एवर सिंस
इट्स रियली बैड आई कुडंट इमेजिन माय बैडेस्ट ड्रीम दैट दिस कुड हैपन विद मी व्हेन समवन आस्क्ड फॉर मॉम्स टू वेयर शी इज व्हाट्स हर नेम आई रियली गॉट कंफ्यूज्ड What to say then?
But then the family have some luck. They meet Dr. Anil Bansal, who has dedicated decades to fighting quacks and assisting their victims.
One lady, poor lady, she was pregnant. She went to a quack for abortion. He started giving medicine. The patient died, and then the quack ran away after closing down the door. After 2 to 3 days, when the foul smelling was coming, people complained, and the police broke open the door. So they found the dead body on the table. This is very horrible. These type of cases are very prevalent in the country. In one more case, we came to know that one of the quack in a hospital was working, and for doing a surgery, he cut the whole intestine, and he told the patient that this is a snake which was in your body, and I removed that one, and that patient ultimately died. So these type of things are happening in the country, so which is very, very dangerous for the common man.
Campaigners like Dr. Bansal face many obstacles. Different forms of healing practice thrive in Indian culture, especially among the poor. Quacks are as common as roadside barbers, and for many poor Indians, they have a place alongside an assortment of healers.
To understand the prevalence of what we call quacks, one has to take a historical perspective to the problem. You know, much like in traditional societies like in China, people have been accessing different forms of care, healthcare. And even in India, for instance, we have lots of localized forms of care. Many consider homeopathy to be unscientific. Similarly, you have Unani, you have Siddha, you have different forms. So it's important to understand the contexts, you know, the local context within which people's preferences for certain types of healthcare emerge.
Traditional medicine, like Ayurveda, is still preferred by many Indians over modern medicine.
Alopecia लेते हैं लोटे से भाई ज़्यादा लेंगे किडनी फेल हो जाएंगी, हार्ट के ऊपर असर करेगा, ब्लड प्रेशर कर देगा खराब, कुछ हो करेगा, इसलिए डरते हैं लोग.
In many Indian cities, nomadic Ayurvedic healers set up shop on roadsides.
हमारा ये कहीं भी टेंट लगता है, तो हम साल छह साल वहीं पे रुकते अपना.
Superstition and spirituality drive people to these healers, whose herbal concoctions promise cures for many different illnesses.
यहाँ पे हम हर तरह का इलाज करते हैं, जैसे मान लो अंडकोष है, सुगर है, एसिडिटी है, गैस है, और जी तुम्हारे कि हाथ पैरों में जोड़ों में दर्द है, गठिया बाई का दर्द है, कुश्ती खाड़े का दर्द है, ये हम हर मर्ज का इलाज करते हैं.
Their success lies in the ability to market their skill.
मान लो जैसे आदमी डॉक्टर के पास चला जाता है, उनके पास कोई दवाई नहीं मिलती, वो निराश होकर चले जाते हैं उसे. हमारे पास आते हैं निराश होकर, ना बैठ जाते हैं, ऐसा ऐसा बात है, हम ठीक नहीं हो पा रहे, ये ढिमका फलाना. मैंने हम कहते भाई यहाँ बैठो आराम से, अपना दिक्कत बताओ, गारंटी से पक्का इलाज हम तुम्हारा करेंगे यहाँ पे.
Few people see a hard and fast boundary between these healers and legitimate medicine. So going to an unqualified doctor who offers cheap treatment is normal. Most common are street-side dentists and so-called ear cleaners, and their services can be just as hazardous as the quacks.
Every day we find some patient coming with perforated eardrum, bleeding from the ear. They not only do procedures, they also put some harmful ear drops, which are hydroxide or very irritating substance.
All over India, people flock to unlicensed bone setters.
ये एक्सरा, ये हड्डी जो है यहाँ से टूटी हुई है, लेकिन इसको मैं बगैर एक्सरे के बता दूँगा यहाँ से टूटी हुई और सेट हो गई, मेरा हाथ बता देगा.
The work of these bone setters can cause infection, deformity, and joint stiffness. But few are deterred.
I will call illiteracy as the major reason behind this. Second major reason behind this appears to me is unpreparedness of our society for surgical procedures.
मेरी फ्रेंड ना मैम को देख के भाग गई थी, तो वो जो पटला था वो गिर गया, तो मैं उस पे से गिर गई थी, तो शुरुआत में इतना दर्द नहीं हुआ, फिर बाद में बहुत दर्द हुआ था, फिर हॉस्पिटल लेके गए थे, वहाँ पे ऑपरेशन बताया था, तो पापा ऑपरेशन नहीं करवाना चाहते हैं, तो यहाँ पे लेके आए थे.
India's quacks have another attraction. In impoverished shanty towns, they live cheek by jowl with potential patients. Biswas calls himself a doctor, but he has no qualifications.
Oh yeah, our guru silo, guru ka satya me RMP, our college pass karwale, all course kese, RMP course karwale, ami oi practice kare.
Even though RMP is not a valid course, his patients still welcome his care.
Kisi pas degree hota na ho, hame to dawai se matlab hai, kyunki dawai se hamare ilaaj sahi se hote hain. जैसे ये डॉक्टर साहब है, इनकी दवाई से तो हम लोग ठीक भी हो जाते हैं, और फैमिली मेंबर की जैसा ही है, क्योंकि कभी भी कुछ होता है तो हम इन्हीं के पास आते हैं.
Biswas sees more than 15 patients a day, and charges each one a paltry 30 cents. But according to quack hunter Dr. Bansal, unqualified practitioners like Biswas may not be aware of the danger of side effects.
In the garb of chief medicines, they are mostly using steroids. Steroids, you know, they are the banned drugs which should not be used without a qualified practitioner's advice. The steroids have to be decreased systematically. These quacks, what they do, they give the steroids which gives a good feeling to the patient, and they suddenly withdraw those also. The withdrawal symptoms, they sometimes are very, very dangerous. Patient can even die also.
In Delhi, the anti-quackery team is preparing a fresh assault on the city's quacks. They rely on reports from the public and from qualified doctors.
We ask the members of public and other doctors, other qualified doctors, to report to us who are the unqualified doctors. So we have a list of thousands of people in Delhi whom we keep receiving that this doctor is doing bad practice, or he's an unqualified person, he's a so-called farji or unqualified doctor.
Key to the operation is a list of individuals practicing without qualifications. For many Indians who fall prey to the quacks, these lists are inaccessible.
India being a large country, having practically 60 to 70% people who are uneducated, that means they do not know a particular person, a particular clinic they are entering is qualified or not.
The team is after two kinds of quack doctor. Some have no qualifications at all, while others are licensed to practice indigenous healing systems like Ayurveda, homeopathy, and Unani. It is illegal for both types to offer mainstream treatments.
Muhammad Rahim, he was having a degree like a bachelor in Unani medical sciences. Obviously, he can pretty well practice Unani, but the drugs which I was keeping was not at all Unani. They are all allopathic drugs.
Some of the worst and most dangerous offenders stock and sell drugs with no knowledge of side effects. Many raids like this are frustrating, but today, the team get a break. The people of the neighborhood direct them to a quack who has been cheating patients. In India, health authorities wage war on legions of quack doctors.
We have to nab them while working. Catch them when it's time.
There was another person, he removed his board also immediately and he ran away.
आप कैमरे पे भी हो, फटाफट खोल दो ताकि ये देखें और बाहर जाएं। कुछ करेंगे थोड़ी, दो मिनट अब खोल दीजिए।
दवाइयां वगैरह सब है की तेरी
दुकान बंद कर दिया हमने पहले क्रोम पे खा मरा दुकान है नहीं
wife hears all the details, although she was denying, but the examination couch and the drugs which were lying there, they pointed to doing a total coactive practice.
मैंने किसी काम से बाहर गया है कि तो बोलते हैं सामान दुकान पे रोड पे था हमारे पास सामान रखा है हम रहते हैं ना देखते हैं हमारा रहते बस घर है सामान
ये दवाई तो आप ही तो
अरे नहीं देता दवाई वाई कुछ नहीं देते
तो ये कौन देता है ये बीपी वगैरह कौन देता है ये दवाई कौन
नाम बताइएगा अपने पति देव का नाम बताइएगा बस नाम तो बताओगी घर का नंबर तो बताओगी
हाँ बताइए
हाँ क्या नाम है आपके हस्बैंड का
गोविंद विश्वास
तो कब से चल रही
है ये होगा 10-15 साल
से ना
एलोपैथी के देते हैं मुझे नहीं पता क्या क्या देते हैं तो पौरे कथा बोलते हैं पौरे
साइन तो आप कर दो ना कि भाई मेरे हस्बैंड
नहीं आता मेरे पे साइन करना
साइन अंगूठा लगाना आता है
अंगूठा
तो आता है
The anti-quackery team that set out to nab the unlicensed practitioners have not completed their mission yet. There is one more practitioner they need to find before their job is done for the day.
We just saw a board and it was written in Hindi that this person can treat hemorrhoids, piles. There was no degree mentioned on that board, so we could pretty well sense that he's a quack. We entered his place. We asked him how many years doing. He said, "I am doing for 5 to 7 years." What are you doing? So he was answerless. He could not answer it convincingly. Then we took photographs of his place, the medicines which he had kept, and he was absolutely defenseless because he did not have any degree. So what was left for us is to make a case against him and police and DMC. If we follow it up, at least we can get rid of at least one person.
The team often hears the same excuse from the quacks they confront.
क्या है अगर सरकार बंद कर देगी तो मजदूरी करेंगे बच्चों को तो मारेंगे तो है नहीं बच्चों को तो जिलाना है मजदूरी करेंगे कहीं फैक्ट्री में नौकरी करें या कहीं बेलदारी करें या कुछ भी करें बच्चों को तो मारेंगे नहीं कि गला घोट दें अपने खुद भी आत्महत्या कर लें या तो ऐसा भी प्रोसीजर आ सकता है सामने हमारे कि हम ज़्यादा टेंशनाइज हो जाएंगे हमारा रोजी रोजगार हमारे बच्चे भूखे मरेंगे तो हम आत्महत्या भी कर सकते हैं
Even if the raid is successful and a closure order issued, there's another problem for the anti-quackery team. Authorities rarely follow up to punish offenders.
Because the quackery is a social issue, and there are multiple agencies involved with dealing with the quacks. And I don't think that there is a proper coordination among the officials of the different systems. Around 300 complaints of the quacks which have asked the police to register an FIR, the FIR has not been registered. In spite of various reminders.
Under an outdated National Anti-Quackery Act of 1956, offenders can be jailed for a year and fined 1,000 rupees. That's about $14. As a result, most quacks can continue to run their business as usual. The Undercover Asia team use a list of exposed quacks who have received closure.
यार सारे डॉक्टर ऐसे ही लिखते हैं दोनों
चल ये एंटीबायोटिक तो नहीं कितना हुआ था
2000
ये बेसिकली इन्फेक्शन के लिए है.
The team reconfirmed that the medicines were indeed antibiotics.
ठीक है ना दा? ठीक है, कोई सारा एंटीबायोटिक नहीं है.
हाँ, क्या नहीं चले?
हैं? ना वो है, क्या नाम है? नॉर्फ्लोक्सासिन है. नॉर्फ्लोक्सासिन का एंटीबायोटिक है ना?
ये बोले नहीं है.
The team heads to the second address on the list. Quackery is a bailable offence in India, which is why offenders are not afraid to restart their practice. The second practitioner spends some time examining the patient, then pulls out medicines from his own collection.
कल आपको दस दिन शाम को आपको दाल नहीं खानी दाल खाने ना कोई दिक्कत हो
team tracks down a third clinic on the closure list, but finds that this too is in operation. At this clinic, the practitioner is absent, but the practice is being taken care of by his wife.
कितने बार गए हो सुबह से
जी हाँ
Next, we take the prescribed treatments to Dr. Chawla of the Delhi Medical Council for analysis.
So interestingly, three of the doctors gave three different sets of medicine from their little knowledge, whatever they have, because they do not have the proper knowledge, they do not conduct proper examination, but they are fully using medicines, because unfortunately in India, you get loose medicines without prescription, which they are openly dispensing to our patients, and whatever harmful effects they are causing, it is unthinkable, but they are going on unabashedly, none stopping them. So they are all strong, reserve category allopathic drugs containing antibiotics also. This contains a powerful salt, ofloxacin and onidazole, with lots of side effects. The effect, these tablets are open tablets. They do not have any strip, so one cannot even know what its content could be, what their expiry are. Maybe they are made 10 years back, maybe they are made 5 years back. They are very cheap tablets. They get it in some wholesale and they give to the patients. Just for a few profits or benefits, they are damaging so many people, and so for so many years, I think it must be stopped by any means.
In the rural heartland of India, healthcare is often worse than in the cities. This is a government primary healthcare center, but it is abandoned. There are no qualified doctors in this village, and the nearest hospital is miles away. Villagers have no means of getting to it in an emergency. Many villagers flock to quacks for cheap treatment. The story is repeated all over rural India. But in one region, an NGO called the Liver Foundation has launched a radical program to combat the shortage of doctors and the menace of fake doctors. Backed by the state government, they are trying to turn poachers into gamekeepers, offering quack doctors training to provide basic services to some of India's poorest citizens.
So far, we have trained approximately 3,000 informal healthcare providers. This is a very basic training to them, and this is a training program we have conducted for 9 months, twice in a week, and it includes all basics of physiology, anatomy, you know, emergency medicine, child care, mother care, public health.
Hundreds travel for miles to attend the course. They have all practiced illegally, but are willing to accept the offer of genuine training.
When I was practicing in 2002, I had antibiotics, all antibiotics, I had all the antibiotics, and I had all the antibiotics, and I had all the antibiotics, and I had all the antibiotics.
On day one, we gave them a SOP sort of thing, what to do, standard operating procedure, or not a practice of their behavior. So we told them that you have to remove the prefix called doctor. And unless you do that, you cannot continue this training. And we used to monitor whether they are doing that or not. And we used to tell that every day that you are not doctors, you are not doctors. By calling yourselves as doctors, you are placing yourselves at a bad predicament, because that's a criminal activity. The country's system can jail you any day, because no person can call themselves as doctors unless that person is MBBS.
Santosh is one of the graduates of the course. He begins his day at 7 a.m. with a long line of patients who come to him with an array of problems. He had picked up the basics of medicine from a doctor friend when he had started out his career. Now he is one of the prized students of the Liver Foundation and the only trained healthcare provider in his village.
Our gram is 12-13 population. সেটা সিংহভাগই আমার উপর নির্ভরশীল আর আমার গ্রামের পপুলেশন ছাড়া পাঁচখানা গ্রাম আমাকে প্রতিদিনই ভিজিট করতে হয় আর এই পাঁচখানা গ্রামের মানুষ কিন্তু আমাকে সকলেই নিজের গ্রামের মানুষ এবং নিজের বাড়ির মানুষ বলে মনে করে
One of his patients is a construction's laborer who suffered a fall and is paralyzed waist downwards. He needs a catheter change every few days. With no other option available, he looks to Santosh for help.
আমাদের এখানে মোটামুটি সরকারি ডাক্তার কোনো যোগাযোগ নেই যেতে গেলে আমরা সিটি সদর হাসপাতাল ডাক্তার এখানে যেতে গেলে বলতে হয় পয়সা পাতির ব্যাপার আছে তো পয়সা পাতির অভাবে আমরা যেতে পারে যেহেতু আমরা সন্তু ডাক্তারকে এনে গ্রামে আনো ট্রিটমেন্টও খাই তো পয়সা পাতি দিতে পারা যায় না সব দিনও লেগেও না যতটুকু দিই ততটুকু
আমার গ্রামের ছেলে সে তো আমারও প্রতিবেশী তাই আমরাই যাই হোক চেঞ্জ করে দিই, দিতে পারলেও ভালো, টাকা না দিতে পারলেও ভালো।
Time will tell whether initiatives like this will work. But across India, schemes like this one to improve healthcare for the poor are few and far between. And in Indian cities, there are few similar training programs. So quacks will continue to harm patients like 12-year-old Bilal, who faces a bitter struggle to win compensation.
मैं चलता हूँ ना तो मेरे पैर में हड्डी वो पैर में ना चलता हूँ जब तो हड्डी चुभती है उसमें पैर में तो दर्द होता है मेरे अम्मी से बोला था ना अम्मी ऑपरेशन कर कराओगे हड्डी है तो अम्मी ने बोला कि पैसे आएंगे जब करा देंगे अभी पैसे नहीं है
The family is desperately short of money and today they are making yet another trip to the lawyer to find out how long it will take to win compensation. The answer is not encouraging.
This is an unfortunate part that we do not have any special courts for such type of cases. In medical negligence cases also, delay is a factor. Sometimes people may not get justice, say, for the next 5 years or 7 years.
Dr. Bansal, who has been fighting court cases against quacks for over a decade, knows that it might take even longer than that.
In India, our court system is so slow that to punish a quack, it takes more than 10 to 12 years. And by that time, the severity of the case or the crime decreases and they are not afraid of.
Bilal and his family are likely to have a long wait. But Dheeraj Solanki, whose wife died at the hands of a quack, has won a remarkable victory. After a long fight, he managed to have the hospital that treated his wife close down.
दिल्ली का पहला केस है कि जिसमें क्वैकरी के चलते इस हॉस्पिटल का लाइसेंस पब्लिक ग्रीवेंस कमीशन के ऑर्डर पे कैंसिल कर दिया गया यही एक थोड़ी बहुत अचीवमेंट कह सकते हैं कि एक आगे कोई हॉस्पिटल कोई क्वैक को रखेगा तो सोचेगा इसके बारे में
But Dheeraj's victory offers scant hope to thousands of victims.
आज मेरा बच्चा है कल किसी और का भी अपाहिज हो सकता है
पूरा सिस्टम ही खराब है
एवरी डिपार्टमेंट including health department, police department, drug control department, they are all involved and these quacks, they bribe them.
The political will to nab them is quite less.
For the campaigners who take on India's fake doctors, there is a daunting obstacle, the legal system. Despite the dedicated work of individual lawyers, offers fragile support and is riddled with loopholes. The quacks continue to thrive because they know they face a near toothless health establishment. Until that is changed and quackery is treated as a serious crime, fake doctors can get away with murder.